Good morning. We'd like to welcome you to the Trinity Baptist Church in Westfield, North Carolina. And if you don't have a church to attend or you're looking for a church to attend, we'd love to take time to invite you to come and be with us in any and all of our services. Our Sunday morning services start at 10 o'clock. We have Sunday school. We have preaching service at 11 a.m., Sunday night service at 6 p.m., and Wednesday night service at 7 p.m. We're located at 1233 Collinstown Road, Westfield, North Carolina. Also, if you'd like to come to the service, but you're not really feeling well and you don't know about coming inside with everybody else, you could just come to the church, sit in the parking lot, tune your car radio or truck radio into 92.9 FM on your radio, and you can hear what's going on inside the services. And I believe that would be a help to you. It's been a help to a lot of people, and we thank God for that. So we just want to make that available, and just glad to be able to have services. Thank God for being so merciful to us and for being so good to us. Be taking that good old authorized King James Bible and turn with us today, if you would, to the book of Luke chapter number 1. Then we'll be flipping back and forth between Luke chapter 1 and Matthew chapter 1. And we're going to go away from the book of Hebrews for this 1 week. I really feel like we need to look at the Christmas story today. I know this is the Sunday before Christmas. We're looking forward to that. And I want to share a little bit of the Christmas story with you, and I hope it'll be a blessing to your heart. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, thank you so much for the privilege to pray. Deal with those that are lost, that they'd call on you and ask you to save them. And those that's backslid, that they'd confess their sins and get right with you, Father. Get back in fellowship with you. I pray for those that are sick, that you'd raise them up physically, meet their need. Please, Lord, help them. And Lord, I want to pray for those folks at the church that's sick, God, that you'd bless them in a great way. We look forward to our services here in just a little while this morning, and Lord willing, tonight. And Lord, I pray you'd bless everywhere that the word of God is preached. And we'll thank you and praise you. I pray for our government. I pray for our president, our vice president. I pray for the salvation of all those in authority over us, if they're not saved, that they'd get saved. And God, help us all to be a blessing to one another. We thank you for this wonderful time of year. Thank you for the Christmas season. And God bless as we look at the Christmas story today for just a few minutes. We'll praise you for all you do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you again for viewing today, and I hope this will be a blessing to you. I love Christmas time. Listen, there's no greater gift that's ever been wrapped than, thank God, that babe that was wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. Listen, there's nothing great, no better present anybody could ever get than the gift of salvation through and by the Lord Jesus Christ. If you don't know him as your Savior, you sure do need to. I pray you'll repent of your sins and call on the Lord and ask God to save you. Christmas is about God. We celebrate Christmas. It's about God giving to us. John 3:16 is a verse not normally associated with Christmas, but it really is, because it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." What a wonderful gift. I just want to take time to read the Christmas story today, and I'll have to just read most of it to get through it. But I hope it'll be a blessing to you today as we do this. And think about it. What a wonderful time. Thank God of year. The Bible tells us in Luke chapter number 1, verse number 26, when the angel Gabriel comes to Mary and tells her what God's plan is for her life. And thank God she's willing to do what God wants her to do. The Bible says in Luke 1:26, and in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, "Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women." And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, "Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. Behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end." Then said Mary unto the angel, "How shall this be, seeing I know not a man?" And the angel answered and said unto her, "The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, the power of the highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth hath also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. Mary is willing to accept what God has for her life. And thank God. Let me just say this quickly and move on. Mary is never to be worshipped. The Bible don't tell us that. The Bible don't teach that. But we should be thankful. We should be thankful. Praise God for Mary. Now in Matthew chapter number 1, verse number 18, the Bible talks about when the angel comes to Joseph and how that God deals with Joseph. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. God picked the perfect people to raise the Lord Jesus Christ. Mary to give birth to God's only begotten son, and Joseph, her espoused husband, which he would marry, to be the one that would raise God's only begotten son. Mary was his mother, God was his father, and Joseph was what we might refer to today as his stepdad. Joseph raised him. Mary and Joseph both were willing to do what God wanted them to do as far as his plan, and we all are beneficiaries of that. Thank God for them being willing to do. Joseph was a just man. He married a woman that was already with child, trusting and believing what the angel had told him, that listen, she hadn't been unfaithful, but praise God, listen, she was carrying the greatest gift that would ever be given. And listen, Mary or Joseph, either one, had to ask anybody, should I do this or can I do this? They were willing to go through any ridicule, any talking about. Hey, they were willing to do that because they knew it was God's will. Let me say this quickly before I go on. It's important for you and me to do the will of God for our lives. It's very important. If God's got something for me to do, I need to do it. If God's got something for you to do, you need to do it. Now, God has dealt with Mary and Joseph about her giving birth to the Lord. Now, back in the book of Luke, chapter number 2, the Bible says in verse number 1, And it came to pass, and I say thank God, and it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. This taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea under the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary as a espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Thank God for God giving us his only begotten son. Thank God for Jesus, God's only begotten son, the word of God made flesh. Thank God he was willing to come into this world and to live a perfect, sinless life, and to die for sinners, men, women, boys, and girls, and thank God, die for their sins. Listen, he shed his blood, he was buried, and on the third day, thank God, he rose again. And he loves you, and he wants to save you. And the greatest gift I have ever received was the free gift of salvation. And it'd be the same for you if you're not saved, if you just call on the Lord. Listen, the shepherds, you can read about the shepherds in Luke chapter 2, verses 8 down through verse number 20. How they came and saw everything just as the angel showed them. And then you can flip back to the book of Matthew chapter 2, where the wise men come later on, a little bit later on, and they worship the Lord and they give him gifts. Let me just say this today in closing. He's worthy. He's worthy of us that are saved, serving Him. It's our reasonable service. God's not asking too much of us to do whatever it is. Listen, it was Mary's. Whatever it is God wants us to do, it's our reasonable service. God wasn't asking too much of Mary. He wasn't asking too much of Joseph. He's not asking too much of you. Listen, if you're lost, I pray you'll get saved. Let's pray. Father, thank you today for the privilege to be able to have this video, and I pray it'll be a help. Thank you for this Christmas season, and we'll praise you for all that you do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you so much for viewing this morning. I hope this has been a blessing to you. And until next week, we'd like to say God bless you is our prayer.